वेलकम टू द अनादर एपिसोड ऑफ पर्सपेक्टिव। टुडे वी हैव शशांक विद अस। ही इज एन एंटरप्रेन्योर हु स्टार्टेड हिज कंपनी जस्ट आफ्टर ही कंप्लीटेड हिज कॉलेज। ही हिज कंपनी स्टोन सेंटा इज इन द स्पेस ऑफ मेकिंग पर्सनलाइज गिफ्ट्स, एंड हिज कंपनी हैज़ बीन सैडली अफेक्टेड बाई कोरोना वायरस क्राइसिस। एंड वील गेट सम मोर परस्पेक्टिव ऑन हाउ एंटरप्रेन्योर और अ बिजनेसमैन हु हैज वर्क सो हार्ड टू गेट हिज कंपनी गोइंग फेसिस द कोरोना वायरस क्राइसिस। सो दिस पॉडकास्ट विल कवर दैट एज वेल। यू विल हेयर द परस्पेक्टिव ऑफ अ बिजनेस गोइंग टू डे जीरो, एंड वॉट आर द मोटिवेशंस और द की पॉइंटर्स विच एन एंटरप्रेन्योर स्टिल हैज विच बेसिकली ड्राइव्स हिम टू अगेन मेक हिज स्टार्टअप अ सक्सेस। सो भाई शशांक, वेलकम टू दिस पॉडकास्ट एंड इट्स ग्रेट टू हैव यू। सो स्टार्ट ऑफ लाइक द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन विच आई वुड लाइक टू आस्क इज व्हाट इज मतलब हाउ डिड यू कम अप विद द नेम स्टोन सैंडा, एंड वील बेसिकली गेट डीप डाउन इन टू इट। लाइक वील टेल द ऑडियंस अबाउट वॉट इज स्टोन सैंडा एटसेट्रा, बट हाउ डिड यू कम अप विद दिस नेम?
Sure. So, when I was thinking of the name and what should I name my company, primarily because Santa is a symbol for bringing in joy through the very act of gifting. That's one. And stoned because memories etched on stone is forever, and I've always been a believer in creating gifts that can, sustain for a life. The value of which keeps increasing with each passing year. And with that, I thought Stone Santa could be a nice. It has this very interesting connect with the youth and the audience of India and abroad. So I thought Stone Santa could be a name which, and people might just remember. So yeah, that's how I came up with the name.
Got it. So everyone who is listening to this, I'll just give you some more perspective on what Stone Santa does. Stone Santa is basically caters to everyone who needs to make a personalized gift for their loved ones, and they also do it in a way that they basically make all the gifts by hand, and they have artists for that as well. So and Shashank, like starting something in this space, right? Personalized gifting space. How did you come up with the idea? And since it's to do this, and what was that basically Eureka moment for you when you came up with this idea of personalized gifting?
I did not really think about the feasibility and the viability much when I got the idea, because at that instant when I got the idea, I was really looking for gifting ideas for my parents' 25th wedding anniversary. And while I was thinking of ideas, I could not really find any. And suddenly this idea struck that, hey, there might be people like me who might be looking for some, unique gifts. And I think for when I got the idea that, hey, something like this might just work. And since I still had 6 months of college left before I graduated, I thought, let's see how it works. Because I did not really think that this is something that will, be a full-time affair for me. But I thought, let's play around with the idea and see how it pans out. And I guess we were lucky enough because in the first 6 months, we found some very interesting customers which gave us enough capital that, we made this decision and I could go full time with this. So that's how it has been for me.
100%, 100%. So you mentioned that you found out some customers in the first 6 months, right? Can you tell me that part of it? Because you also posted a LinkedIn, you also made a LinkedIn post where you wrote a deep down insight on how your sales journey began, right? So to everyone who is listening, can you give an idea on what sort of, how did you bring on the first set of customers, and how did you basically, so basically that was a kickstart to your startup, right? A lot of people fail to do that. And that is the first step where you actually got an incentive कि मैं आगे भी करना चाहता हूँ. And those 6 months have been very lucky for you, as you mentioned. So how did you get those first set of customers, and what was the journey from zero to one?
So, when I got the idea of Stone Santa, I did not really that gotten myself into. So, started speaking with college juniors, batchmates about how they have been for their loved ones. And based on the survey that I did, I understood that these people remember majorly the gift lies for them, or you know, that was handcrafted for them. And doing a set of initial surveys, I reached out to all those people who showed interest in the possibility of a handmade gift. And I think I would have spoken with around 500-600 people during these 6 months, and that helped us find our first 100 customers.
It was 500-600 customers you reached out to.
500-600 people, you know, college seniors, school juniors, everybody else. And out of these 500-600 people, probably 100 people made purchases. Big, small amounts, that's a different story. But yes, that's how it was.
Got it. So basically, you would ask them, how do you like the idea? And they would obviously tell you tell their experience to you in this space, like how has personalized gifts changed? And basically, right, I also feel that personalized gifts are a great way to express emotions. And even a greater value gets attached to the personalized gift if there is some work done through hand. Because see, like if I would have to get a gift, right, and it was handmade, I would value it more than something which was actually. So let's say if someone orders a pre-made headphones for me, right, I won't be that happy if someone in this age and if in this day and age would make a handicraft, make a card by their hands and gift it to me, because that also gets a set of emotions with that, right? The handicraft part also gets a set of emotions. And that is where I think the personalized gifts also hit well with that sort of demographic, right? So what was the key demographic of this this entire idea? Who were the kind of audience which you were reaching out to in your initial days, and how you basically twist and pivoted your idea to make it which basically is a mass appeal for?
So, I mean, the kind of people we reached out to when I had started versus the kind of people we serve today, there has been a major shift in the demographics, because earlier I was surrounded by college students. And for some reason, I thought that college students are going to be my potential customers. So I kept chasing them for a long, long time. And although they did make that they had was not really so high, you know. Because dependent on their parents and their and everything else. So we kept chasing college students and similar student profiles for almost 1 to 1.5 years of our journey. I realized that the amount of hard work that is put in customers and then serve them can be tricky. So we made a shift and we started reaching out to those people who are about to get married or have important anniversary dates coming up. So we moved from major occasions like birthdays to anniversaries, because in case of anniversaries and weddings, the intent of gifting is very high and very strong. And at such moments, would you want to spend on personalized experiences? Because birthdays keep coming and going. The chances of you looking for a really personalized present for a birthday might not be that very not that high, but in terms of wedding or an engagement gift, you really want it to be a one-time thing. So that's how the transition came in for us when it comes to chasing demographics of our potential customers.
Got it. So the entire website and the look and feel of it would have also changed because of the entire demographic shift, right? As in terms of first you were catering to college students, and then you're catering to people who basically were celebrating their anniversaries and occasions which were more frequent. So has the look and feel of the website and the type of product has always been changing for you, like for Stone Santa?
Right. So yes, the first 2 years on Santa, we were selling everything that we could when it comes to personalized gifts. But after that, we later realized that, hey, selling everything possible under the sun can be a little difficult, and it can really become confusing. So we started focusing on a couple of look and feel of the website has evolved and has changed, because the first version of the website was just an Instagram page. Right? It was like an Instagram page on stonecenter.in with a few lines here and there. But the website has changed significantly since then, because our use cases, the way we want to present our brand to the audience, a lot of things have changed. It's important that we evolve evolved our website too.
Correct, correct. So how do you make money with Stone Santa? Can you sort of give an idea of your business model if someone is jumping into the personalized gift space, right? You completely changed the way you cater to audience by bringing the handicraft element. And that was the biggest selling point because it basically gets a set of values with it. So can you explain what was your business model and how you like the end-to-end processes, what used to happen in the back end of Stone Santa? Like, how do you used to get orders, get the gifts done and deliver the gifts?
Sure. So, the way it works for us is we charge the customer an X amount. We pay the artist a certain percentage of that X amount.
Huh? And,
based on the difference that is there, that is what is Stone Santa's profits. And when it comes to the operations, so the way it usually works is, let's say you're looking for a gift. So what we'll do is we'll present you with the options and the possibilities of what all the things that you can buy as a gift. And if you do like and you purchase, the artist will be assigned the work. And we'll keep sharing work in progress pictures with you so that you and your decision makers can have a look and feel that, okay, the right. And if everything goes as per plan, we wait for the you to give your approval, and if the approval is done, we process and ship it to you. And upon receipt, our team reaches out to our customers, and then we try understanding if they like the gift or if they love the gift. And based on the feedback, we try improving ourselves.
Got it. Also, right, the thing which inspired me in college, I have looked at you because we were basically in the same university, aur maine dekha hai ki aapne 6 mahine jo end ke the, when you started Stone Santa out, it was not an easy task for someone to do that, right? Like when you're going to end your college and you would have a lot of obstacles in your mind, basically ki aap ab kya karoge, kahan se aapki life start hogi, aage kya karna hai. And at that particular point in time, you basically had the courage to go out and start Stone Santa. Matlab, aapke saath kya kya dikkat hai? Matlab, it would be great if you can tell all those in detail. Meko maza aayega sunne mein. I am very interested for this segment ki what were the problems you faced majorly in the starting days of Stone Santa, and how was the transition like from the college life to being a full-time entrepreneur, hustling through like the morning classes, or how your college exams used to be, and also maintaining a team of some people and getting work done from artists and giving it back to people who have ordered the gifts. How was the entire journey like?
There were challenges definitely, because I did not know how to draw and do anything. So that's not an artist. I'm still not an artist. I can't draw for shit.
Yeah.
Second aspect, I didn't know much about business. I mean, business and stuff. No idea, no clue at all. So these two hurdles of not having any prior experience was one of the things. This was in the initial days. And I got a lot of people to volunteer. You know, people were looking to work for an exciting startup idea, drop me a text. So we got like 30-40 people who were interested, and I got all of them in. Like, we created a WhatsApp group the thing is, we didn't know what to do. So finding a team was like what for me. So we had like a team of volunteers, and honestly, the first 6 months, we had no clue. We were doing anything and everything that came and presented itself in front of us. But after graduation, you know, it was really difficult because we were not making enough revenues that I could pay myself a salary and still sustain in a city like Bangalore. So that's when I went forward for an internship with one of the companies that was again started by alumni, Mohammed Zeeshan. So
the climber, right?
Yes, correct. So I worked with him for like 6 months as an intern, and while I was working as an intern, I also got to stay with him without having to pay rent. So that was kind of cool for me, like, you know, stress-free at one part. During these 6 months, I learned a few things about sales, marketing, and things here and there. But the most challenging aspect that comes in is you breaking free from that student entrepreneur wala mindset.
Correct.
Matlab, you want to be doing a lot of things all by yourself because you can't trust anybody else. You Correct. Thinking that everybody is my customer. My idea is so great that everybody is my customer. So those are, you know, some very counterintuitive things, but some very foolish things that a person does when they start off, especially in college.
So, can you list those foolish things like in this segment? Can you just quickly list down those foolish things as well, which you sort of did in that particular time?
Sure. So one of the foolish things that everybody is my customer. So focusing on every aspect, every segment, be it students, be it Valentine's gift, be it return. That was one. Second would be doing everything all by myself, that, hey, I cannot trust anybody else. Let's work.
Correct.
So that was one thing. Third, it would be not spending money. So marketing requires that you spend.
Got it.
So not spending money is something that stuck around with me for a long time, 2.5 years to be very precise. Because if I would have spent money on marketing, I probably would have gotten results faster. But again, for the best, because if I was not spending money on marketing, I was still figuring out how to market my company. And that is when I started writing on Quora to build it on. What are the possibilities of me being able to leverage on this audience and see if I can get customers. So that kind of helped me in build a decent enough profile on Quora. And that got me into the habit of writing.
It's not decent enough. It was 5 million views on a single post. I know that story. So you better not be modest by saying that it is just decent.
What I'm trying to say here is that this journey, as you mentioned out rightly, it's about realizing yourself. So one of the key aspects of me still being in the student entrepreneur mindset was doing things whenever I felt like ha man kiya to ye kaam kar liya aaj, man kiya to ye kal kiya, not following a process, okay. Not being disciplined about of aspects wherein I was still a child student entrepreneur when it comes to the mindset of the thought. And coming through that, being able to realize that, hey, what I was thinking was wrong or probably could have been done better in a different way, I guess takes time. I think it takes time.
Yeah, correct. In this entire phase, right, did you ever regret ki you should have done a job back then? And matlab, अगर मैंने कुछ स्टार्ट किया होता, मैंने कॉलेज में किया था, ठीक है, एक चीज स्टार्ट की थी एंड दैट फेल्ड मिजरेबली एंड एट दैट टाइम आई ऑलवेज यूज टू रिग्रेट कि यार काश मैं ना मतलब जॉब कर लेता, काश मैंने ये चीज की नहीं होती, काश मैं मतलब विश आई वाज जस्ट डूइंग माय नॉर्मल स्टडीज एंड गोइंग फॉर अ जॉब. व्हेन दैट स्टेबिलिटी हिट्स यू, राइट, अनस्टेबिलिटी हिट्स यू, तब कुछ समझ में नहीं आता, देन यू जस्ट फील लाइक कि जस्ट लेट्स गो बैक टू जीरो एंड नॉट डू दिस एनी मोर. Did that happen anytime with you? मतलब आपके साथ ऐसा कभी हुआ था?
Recently. So I mean, there is a lot of energy that was there. So I was lucky that I didn't come in until ये लगा कि I should have taken up a job. But I was still positive that I'll be able to come out of this. But as months progressed, we saw a decline in orders. And a lot of other things started happening, which was not very good for the mental health. And then suddenly, you know, I sense in myself. And then I was like, okay, there should have been some form of stability that I would have had. And so, ha, matlab, aisa time aata hai jab aap, you're going to be full of self-doubt.
Yeah.
And all you can see is that I should quit. I did a wrong thing, or I should not have started up, or I should not have done this. But in the longer run, that is something that helps. It's just that in the shorter run, you might feel bad. And what the thing is, I'm not even sure about what is going to happen in the future. But I had come at this one point when I thought that I'm going to give up and I'm going to shut down my company. This was
correct
post-corona.
Correct.
But then for some reason, I thought that, hey, I've worked on this hard enough. I've worked and given my best, and it has given me a lot of things, this journey. I cannot just end it. So right now my priority is to be taken such that I'm able to, you know, invest 2 to 3 hours of my time every day and still be able to run operations. And I started seeing this as an opportunity to be, you know, taking this as a more premium brand. So instead of serving, let's say, 100 customers a month, I'd rather focus on just serving 20. But the idea is to gain the same amount of revenue, probably.
Has your focus changed to B2B as well, like in the recent times?
Well, yes. So whenever, as I mentioned, from 200 customers a month, I'm aiming to get just 20 customers a month, right? So my goal is that these 20 customers should be the kind of people come back to me again and again, which is very much possible in the case of B2B partnerships. And
correct.
The idea is to reach up to that kind of segment of the people who really have a thing for personalization or, you know, art.
Got it. Yeah. Yep.
Yeah.
Correct. So also, just coming back to the college days when you were transitioning in that particular phase, right? So you mentioned that there were a lot of challenges in terms of getting the right team. Basically, there were a lot of personal hindrances where you were not good at a particular thing, right? So when you were not good at making basically drawing, or you were not good at being an entrepreneur, what was that one thing that took you so far in your journey? Basically, you managed to build a team, you had a proper office with yourself, you managed to get a lot of customers for Stone Santa, and it was running pretty well, right, in the past recent times. So how did you manage to do all that without you totally admit that you didn't know how to start a business? So how did you learn through the process? Can you also take us through that? And what was that one thing which actually took you so far?
I don't know. I mean, I really don't have a straight answer to this question. One thing that I know is in the past 3.5 years, there has been like a lot of things that have happened. A lot of things. I mean, it's been crazy doing a lot of things. I don't even remember half of the things I've done in the very early stages. So what I think is, you know, doing something again and again, again and again, every day, you start finding patterns, you start getting better. So I think that could have been one thing where I started getting better at different aspects of my life. When it comes to delegation, it involved working with hundreds of people as interns, as part-timers, and then understanding, okay, this is the kind of people we might require as a full-time affair. So that's one. Second, when it comes to doing marketing and sales, initially I did not really know what to do when it comes to marketing and sales. So I would shame everybody and everybody I would meet. So these 3 years, I would have talked to about 5,000-6,000 people virtually, or, you know, in person or over the phone. And in doing so, I realized my communication skills improved. That's what I kind of learned, how to carry conversations forward. Is that helped me in understanding marketing and sales. And once I kind of got a little hold on that, I was able to find people who have a similar understanding of marketing and sales. So I guess all in all, if I can summarize this answer, it would all be a lot of iterations. I don't even remember the first few iterations. So,
got it.
So,
jumping to the next phase of your life where you got incubated in NSRCEL, and that was something which I really looked up to, and a lot of people who want to become entrepreneur would have definitely looked up to, and like it's a dream to basically work in IIM Bangalore. How was that experience like? How was that NSRCEL experience?
So NSRCEL came in as a blessing because it helped me shape my mindset more than anything else. It became a platform for me wherein I was constantly challenged. Otherwise, I did not really have anybody who I was answerable to earlier. So being at a position where I was answerable to someone gave me a lot of reality check. That is definitely there. But most importantly, NSRCEL came in as a place wherein it helped me escape my student entrepreneurial mindset. Talked about it. It helped me focus that, hey, you don't have everybody as your customer. You need to be able to find your customer here. It made me accountable to them. It made me accountable to their team. It made me learn how to follow process instead of just doing anything all by myself.
Correct.
So I think NSR came in as a blessing. And at the same time, I had an office space and it was like a pretty cool thing to say that, hey, I am working in NSR cell.
Yeah. And to be surrounded by everyone from IIM Bangalore is also a great deal. Like, you learn a lot from the people around you. Did you ever get a chance to interact with the students there as well?
Oh, yes. So the IIM Bangalore community is very active when it comes to them wanting to learn and know about startups. So during the time while I was working in SARCEL, there was a lot of opportunity where, you know, we got to interact with college students. A lot of time, the MBA students will come in and help us with different use cases. So it was like a beautiful workplace, getting connects in the office. Came in very easily just because of the network that and the community that was there.
Yeah. And for everyone who is listening, right, NSRCL would be a very new term to them. So could you briefly explain what NSRCL? I just want that everyone who is listening to this has some perspective on it.
Sure. So NSRCL happens to be the incubation center for IIM Bangalore. Now, it happens to be one of the oldest startup incubators in India. So they have multiple programs through which they take a startup into their programs, and they help a startup with the basic infrastructure that might be required to take them from step 0 to step 1 or step 1 to step 10. So it stands for NS Raghavan Cell for Entrepreneurial Learning.
Got it. Okay.
And what are those three programs which you mentioned? Matlab, kya kya hote hai wo? I'm really curious to know is there like different stages they cater to, different stages of a startup?
Yeah, the first stage is a launchpad program, wherein your startup, if it is selected, they'll take you through a 3-month journey, wherein they'll teach you different aspects of a startup, give you goals, targets. Mm. And if you perform well during these 3 months of the launchpad program, is when you jump on to the incubation program and you're eligible for a 1-year extension. Mm-hmm. Wherein, you know, the NSRCL team will give you an office for space for the next 1 year, and they'll take you through another journey wherein they'll help you build your startup and make it a company.
Got it.
So that's one. And then they have a program for the women. It's called the Women Startup Program.
Mm-hmm.
And it invites and gives them infrastructure and everything else that might be required to help them grow.
Got it. And so the office space is completely free, or they take something in return? What's the structure like?
So yeah, there are a couple of things that happen. Once if you are getting incubated, then your company will have to give a certain stake of equity in there to IIM Bangalore. So that's one.
How much is that?
I'm not sure. From us, it was 5%.
Okay.
But I think the program has made some changes, and it might be a little different for the different programs.
Got it. So coming back to Stone, correct? Like, you were the single person who was working full time in Stone Santa, right?
For almost 1.5 to 2 years.
Dude, that's great. Like, I can't even tell you how much I can how much inspiration I draw from you, because like, to single-handedly work on your idea and be that passionate for 1.5 years is really difficult for a lot of people out there. Like, it takes great courage to completely be a one-man show and run this whole thing. So yeah. And and also, right, so when you work as a solo entrepreneur, there are also some mental challenges you face when you don't find that first guy who you can be co-founders with, and also the first guy or any person who would be who is aligning to the same vision as you are watching for, or as you have for the company. So that also calls out for a lot of mental stress, because then you have to handle marketing, sales, you have to get orders, get the delivery, have to basically complete the deliveries, etc. Basically, you have to make sure that deliveries are done at the end. So, what were some of the mental struggles you faced through this journey? What was that aspect where you faced ki yaar, matlab what basically troubled you in this entire journey?
I think incompetence can become one very crucial factor. So
As in?
for me, a lot of times I would feel that I'm incompetent. Whatever I know or whatever I've done is not enough. And that is something, and again, it's always good to have somebody who you can share your troubles with, right? Ki haan, ye ho gaya, and
Correct.
my customer got angry. So yeah, theek hai, it's as a company. While you're building a company, yes, you have to always listen to your customers, your artists, and everything else. But यार अब मैं भी तो इंसान ही हूँ ना, कभी 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 लग जाता है बुरा, तो आपको आपके पास
डेफिनेटली
वेंट आउट करने के लिए कोई नहीं रहता. तो कई बार क्या होता है ना, आप ये सारी चीजें इग्नोर करते हो और फिर एक दिन फटता है, एक दिन आपका दिमाग अचानक फटता है, एंड आप यू यू फील एवरीथिंग इज ओवर. तो
नो मैन, आई टोटली रिलेट, क्योंकि इफ यू आर वर्किंग यार, आप अकेले काम कर रहे हो, यू हैव टू कस्टमर्स गालियां देते हैं, ठीक है, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, एंड यू कैन नॉट बी ऑलवेज राइट इन व्हाट यू डू, इन टर्म्स ऑफ ऑपरेशंस, एंड सिंगल हैंडली टू डू एवरीथिंग. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल मैन, यू आर नॉट इनकॉम्पिटेंट, गेट दैट थिंग आउट ऑफ योर हेड इफ यू स्टिल हैव दैट, बिकॉज मैं आपको बताता हूँ, देर आर लॉट ऑफ पीपल हु ड्रीम ऑफ बिकमिंग एन एंटरप्रेन्योर, एंड नॉट लॉट ऑफ पीपल कैरी आउट दिस जर्नी ऑन देयर ओन. आप NSRCL में गए, आपने पूरी टीम हायर की, यू वर्कड एज एन इंटर्न इन अ स्टार्टअप, मेड 50K आउट सेल्स, आप सेल्स जानते हो, आपको मार्केटिंग भी आती है, कोरा में आपकी 5 मिलियन, आई एम नॉट एट द स्टेज वेयर यू आर एट, सो यू शुड नॉट से कि आप इनकॉम्पिटेंट हो, यू शुड कम्प्लीटली गेट दैट आउट ऑफ योर हेड, बिकॉज आई ड्रॉ लॉट ऑफ इंस्पिरेशन फ्रॉम यू एंड जीशान, बिकॉज आई हैव सीन यू गाइज ग्रो फ्रॉम SRM यूनिवर्सिटी. But coming back to the point, what were the other things which basically troubled you?
It's majorly just this. I mean, there is so much workload to do. I mean, it becomes unexplainable at times, but I guess it is all a part of the journey. That is,
Correct.
you have self-doubt, you'd want to quit, you'd feel that everything that you did is waste. I guess
Correct.
it is a phase, and you get to learn how to live through it.
बट यार हर रोज मुश्किल होता है ना, कि आप यू आर सिंगल हैंडली डूइंग दैट एवरी डे, सो ऐसे भी फेज आते थे दैट इट वुड बी जस्ट अ बर्स्ट ऑफ जॉय, कि कुछ ऐसा अच्छा हो गया, व्हाट वर दोस, एक तो टर्निंग पॉइंट आई नो दैट इट वाज NSRCL, बट व्हाट एल्स वाज दैट पॉइंट व्हिच मेड यू रियली हैप्पी इन योर एंटरप्रेन्योरियल जर्नी, बिकॉज सी देयर आर ब्राइटर साइड्स टू इट एज वेल, यू हैव बीन थ्रू अ लॉट ऑफ डार्क डेज, आई कुड सी दैट, बट आपके पास ऐसे कुछ मोमेंट्स आए होंगे व्हिच बेसिकली वर वर्थ फॉर दोस, वर्थ था वो सब जो हुआ, वो वर्थ था फॉर दोस पर्टिकुलर डेज, सो व्हाट वर दोस स्मॉल विक्ट्रीज इन योर जर्नी व्हिच यू हैड, व्हाट वाज दोस?
So one of the things was I carried out this crazy marketing campaign wherein I went on to the Bangalore airport and we advertised in 400 cabs by speaking with the cab drivers individually one by one.
And what did
Now,
they do in exchange? Fuck, dude, you did that.
so we didn't get them. So we just talked to them and we shared our story that hey, this is what we do. We make handmade art and we help artists earn and get recognized for their work. So we did not really have to tell them that hey, please let us advertise. They understood it automatically, and the best part was they didn't want anything in return financially.
Got it.
So
Got it.
it was like a very humbling moment, because I learned this one very important thing in life. If you want something, you can always seek help, and you'll be amazed at the number to help you.
Correct,
And
correct.
that cab campaign kind of went a little crazy. It went viral. It was the only shot at virality that I had. And I received hundreds of messages saying that, hey, crazy campaign, crazy campaign. And
Oh,
that
nice.
was one moment wherein I felt that, okay, it's worth everything, doing everything.
तो आप लोग क्या करते थे, कैब फॉर एग्जांपल, यू टॉक टू अ ड्राइवर, राइट? नाउ नेक्स्ट, व्हाट इज द कॉन्वर्सेशन व्हिच यू एंड द ड्राइवर वुड हैव, कैन यू बेसिकली गिव मी अ सेंस ऑफ दैट, एंड व्हाट
Sure.
डिड यू प्रमोट इट इन देयर कैब्स? काफी
So
इंटरेस्टिंग यार.
आई वॉज एट दी बैंगलोर एयरपोर्ट, मतलब 5th of August 2018 आई सेट आउट टू दी बैंगलोर एयरपोर्ट विद वन ऑफ आवर टीममेट संजय. नाउ एट बैंगलोर एयरपोर्ट वी स्टार्टेड टॉकिंग टू द कैब ड्राइवर सेइंग दैट हाय अन्ना आई एम माय नेम इज शशांक आई स्टार्टेड माय कंपनी एंड आई हैड माय स्केचेस इन माय हैंड्स नॉट माय स्केचेस बट यू नो आई हैड सम स्केचेस इन माय हैंड सो आई वुड शो इट टू देम एंड दे ऑटोमेटिकली अंडरस्टैंड बिकॉज़ दोस placards that are planned for had an elastic so they would be like automatically understand that how do you want to put this in our cab and I'm like yes and a lot of cab drivers showed that their children were artists or their elder brother was an artist so basically what happened was during that time we made a connect with the cab drivers
correct
we had tea with them lunch
oh nice
and matlab you'll not believe this but jahan pe jo airport jahan pe tha main that was 200 meters from the airport, P6 parking.
Okay.
In Bangalore. And उस कैंटीन में इडली 25 रुपए में मिलती है. And I remember मैंने इडली खाया था एयरपोर्ट के अंदर 250 रुपए में. So I could see the world exist in just just 200 meters का distance.
Correct.
So वो जो पूरा एक्सपीरियंस था मैं आपको बता नहीं सकता हूँ. But I think that was one of the best things in my life. It gave me a lot of learning and confidence.
यार मतलब ये तो काफी interesting है because I'm just visualizing the kind of situation it would have been and so the thing is the amount of good feel you get from doing these kind of campaigns is because you get to interact with people on a ground level and the feedback loop is sort of faster because people give the response if they like the campaign or not. And you also make a customer if they really liked your product. This is an automatic sales which happens, right? And you actually targeted a great place to start with because लोग थोड़ा emotional भी होते होंगे कि मतलब मैं कुछ handmade gift दे देता हूँ अपनी मम्मी को who is still in Jaipur maybe और मैं Bangalore आ गया हूँ, right? So that was a great place to start with. Did you do any more campaigns like that in future? उसके बाद?
It's Valentine's Day 2020. So we stood in on the streets of Kormangla and we put up placards. Haath mein placard pakad liya that too broke to advertise. Google Stone Santa. Love is in the air.
Nice.
Love is in the air. So is coronavirus. Google Stone Santa.
If
our startup was funded, we wouldn't be here.
Oh, epic, epic.
So hua kya? Hum aise khade the. In front of Bangla and a lot of people stopped to click pictures. That was one. And second, one of the cops, he came down and he thought that we were protesting against CAA and NRP. So, and it was an eventful day. Yeah.
Yeah. like great experiences, man. Ye sahi campaigns hai. Like I am a full-time marketer. But when it comes to on-ground campaigns, this is a great way to do it. This is a great way to do it. You could have done this more often, like with Valentine's Day, logon ke anniversaries mein. Like even in the... There could have been a lot of occasions where you could have done this. Kaafi interesting, yaar.
Yeah, matlab har baar aisa crazy. We cannot just go and be crazy all the time. So...
Kaafi fun nahi hai, matlab... Imagine this, like you are getting to do all of this with your own company. तो कितना मतलब life में kick आती है ना?
हाँ वही है kick लाने के लिए कर रहे थे हम.
Correct. Yeah, like just coming over to the final segment of this podcast, and it's basically something which a lot of listeners have to. I genuinely wanted to keep this segment at the end because a lot of listeners should know this. And a lot of listeners should know the business side of things also. I know a lot of people are getting fired and there has been a major financial crisis all over the world right now. Like everyone is going through this. I'm not trying to give any gyan, but this is what happens realistically with an entrepreneur or with anyone who has been getting fired. Also, to understand the business side of it, right? आप एक बात बताओ, how did you deal with all this? And can you also tell our audience ki what happened with your startup?
All right, sure. So that is something that it took me a lot of time to make peace with. So what happened is the lockdown happened and everybody moved back to their hometowns. I mean, I had come down to my hometown and so did my team. Now what happens is the pandemic opened up a door of insecurities and uncertainty.
Correct.
So my team being very young, of people who had just freshly graduated out of college, their priorities kind of shifted because their priorities shifted. And majorly what also happened was unke parents' ki priorities also shifted.
Okay.
So basically one by one, over the course of 3 months, I saw my teammates drop. I was almost alone now.
Okay.
Ab aise case mein, matlab after 3 years of doing something, you go back alone. So it's not a good mental phase for you. You're like, what was the point of me working so hard for something wherein I'm back to, I'm back to being alone again.
Correct.
So at that point of time, I kind of lost all confidence that I had in myself. I was like, okay, there's no point. And if my teammates have left me, that does mean that I have not been able to build a decent company. So there was like 1,000 sets of questions that started coming to my mind. And moreover, the thought that started coming into my head was, ab corona aa gaya hai, people will not buy gifts anymore because people are going to be concerned about their health and everything else.
Correct.
Which is partly true, but which is still not true.
People would have been placing orders, right?
People were not placing orders, but after the lockdown opened, we started getting inquiries.
Okay.
But the thing is, mentally, I had thought, okay, this is the end.
Hmm.
But then when I thought that, okay, I'm going to, shut it down because there's nobody else. Those few days or few weeks, it was terrible. I would force myself to sleep so that I could escape reality. But then, I don't know why, my mother gave me a lot of strength. She told me that, why are you shutting it down? Do it part-time. You still can. Because, see, care. Ab kiya hai to kiya hai. Don't quit on your dreams. All you can do is delay your dreams.
Correct.
And a person who does not think smartly at this point of time is somebody who's going to be like a super fool. So I did not want to be that guy who is not able to understand the situation and mold accordingly.
Correct.
So right now, I had to make this decision. So right now, the thing is, I have decided to work on my startup, Stone Santa, part-time, as much my time allows and permits.
Correct.
And apart from that, I'm doing a couple of freelance projects.
Yeah.
And then something I really enjoy doing is teaching. So I take classes on entrepreneurship for college students every month. It's like a series of 8 live discussions that happen over a month.
Correct.
2 per week.
Correct.
And so establish certain sets of skills which gives me a form of work at
Correct.
The same time. It pays me well. And I might have to be looking for a job for a while in the future. So the idea is to be open to anything that the world presents to you. And at the same time, not lose a track of
Correct.
Why you started what you started. Because, I mean, yeah, that is the truth.
Yeah, this is a thought which I'll take back from this podcast because I know that life is uncertain and there will be a lot of situations which are not in our hands and not in our control. And a lot of businesses have boomed also, as in the edtech space has greatly has doubled their revenues because people have started to learn from home, etc. But there are some companies which will be revamped after the lockdown gets over and people will actually start putting their money in that. But nevertheless, I would take the end segment from this podcast as a learning for my entire life. Also, just another question was what happened to the artists who were associated with you? Are you still in touch with them? How has coronavirus affected them?
Oh yeah, sure. So yeah, I am in touch with them. A couple of artists who belonged to some rural backgrounds, they took a severe hit on the business. But right now what's happening is we are still giving them orders. It is not as much as it was pre-corona, but My idea is to again, build a sustainable channel wherein I'm able to find enough customers for 1 month, which can keep my company alive and running. At the same time, give opportunities to these artists who
करेक्ट
had no other
करेक्ट
source
करेक्ट
of income. And right now, we are operating at probably 10% of the revenues that we did in
करेक्ट
Feb 2010-20. But my idea is to take this to probably at least 60-70% of what revenues and profits we had in March and Feb of 2020. Even if I am 20% working on this full time, and I think that is pretty much possible because all the experiences and learnings that I've had, I can start putting all of that into use and be a little more selective about
The
what
other day also
customer
we were on a
sizes.
call discussing the same thing, and basically I have the same I basically see you as a very optimistic person about life, and मतलब सब इंसान है, सो यू वुड ऑल्सो फेस सम डिफिकल्ट टाइम्स, बट द ओनली थिंग यू हैव टू मेक श्योर कि मतलब हो सकता है, मतलब लाइक आफ्टर द लॉकडाउन ऑल्सो इट इज देर इज अ स्ट्रॉन्ग पॉसिबिलिटी दैट पीपल विल स्टिल पुट देयर मनी इन पर्सनलाइज गिफ्ट्स, एंड या सो एंड अगेन लाइक यू आर नॉट एट योर डे जीरो, यू स्टिल हैव अ लॉट ऑफ एक्सपीरियंस विच यू हैव लर्न थ्रू द कोर्स ऑफ 3 years, एंड यू विल डेफिनेटली पुट दैट इन एंड स्टार्ट अफ्रेश, सो जस्ट टेक दिस एज अ फ्रेश सॉर्ट ऑफ स्टार्ट टू योर एंटायर विजन, दिस कैन बी द अदर वे टू लुक एट इट. प्लस ऑल्सो राइट, when do you plan to get back in Bangalore as soon as this pandemic ends and you to start the company full time after this pandemic gets over?
Honestly, I don't want to leave home for the next few months. I'm planning to live with my parents now, and taking Stone Santa full time might not be a possibility for the next 2 to 3 years, because right now I think I'm going to be pursuing definitive sources of personal income so that I'm able to
Correct, correct.
keep my parents happy. I mean, my parents have given me the freedom to pursue and chase my dreams for almost
Correct,
3.5 years of
yeah.
my life. And whatever happened, it might not have been my mistake entirely, but I think the truth of the matter is the pandemic has hit a lot of
Correct.
businesses and a lot of people hard. And the only thing that I can do right now is
Correct.
appreciate what I have and do what's right. So at this point of time, I feel for me, what is right would be focusing on building a stable source of income for myself, probably prepare myself and get married in the next 2 3 years, after 2 to 3 years, and see what life has to go. But one thing that I'll be doing during these 2 to 3 years is I plan on creating a lot of content, video and textual content, because that is something I really enjoy doing. And if things pan out, I might just be able to leverage this personal brand and take Stone Santa to
Correct,
another
correct,
level
correct, correct.
altogether.
Shashank, all the best for everything you do in future. It was a great podcast. And also, I would still say that the entire 3 years of journey, you have learned a lot from people who have been doing shitty jobs in TCS or Infosys. Like I'm very opinionated about this fact, because I strongly believe that it's not about the number of years of experience you do. Basically the number of experience you have, it's basically the number of experiences you have. It's not the years of experience. So you have probably been someone who has chased different experiences rather than chasing the number of years of experience. And from my perspective, there is nothing to be disheartened about. And who would be a better person to be an entrepreneur again? And you might just come up with another idea apart from Stone Santa and just make it a big success. So with this, I would like to end the podcast, and all the best for everything, man.
Thanks so much for your time, Sagar. It was really fun, and I really like the flow of how you followed up with questions one by one, and it was really fun. And I did not even realize that we are done and through with 1 hour.
Yeah, and personally,
but
and
I
I
mean,
used to sort of admire you from college, and this is sort of a chance. This was sort of a chance for me to basically connect you on a human level, one on one, and basically get this conversation going for at least an hour. I wouldn't have imagined that in the college, at least. But hey, man, it was great pleasure. It was great pleasure to have you on the podcast. Thanks a lot.